Welcome to Ahmed's World, where we delve into the wonders of our planet's past. In this episode, we journey back to the Paleocene Epoch to uncover the fascinating tale of Titanoboa, the colossal serpent that once ruled the ancient swamps of Colombia. Get ready for an adventure into a world that time has nearly forgotten. Titanoboa was an enormous, now extinct snake that roamed the Earth during the Paleocene Epoch, approximately 66 to 56 million years ago. It is recognized as the largest known member of the suborder serpents. Fossil evidence, dated to between 58 and 60 million years ago, has provided insights into its size. Paleontologists estimate that an average adult Titanoboa could reach about 13 meters, 42.7 feet, in length and weigh around 1,135 kilograms, 1.25 tons. This giant snake is thought to be related to modern anacondas and boas, although it remains unclear whether it is more closely linked to one or the other of these contemporary constrictors. Titanoboa was first identified in 2009, 5 years after its fossils were discovered in the Serpent coal mine in Colombia, located west of Lake Maracaibo. Approximately 30 individual specimens have been unearthed, mostly adults, though some juveniles have also been found. The fossils primarily consist of vertebrae and ribs, which is typical for snake remains. It's estimated that Titanoboa had over 250 vertebrae. One nearly complete specimen, including a skull, has been recovered. The large number of similar-sized individuals suggests that lengths of around 13 meters were common for adults of this species. In contrast, adult anacondas typically measure about 6.5 meters, 21.3 feet, with record-breaking individuals reaching around 9 meters, 29.5 feet. No living snake has been confirmed to exceed 9.6 meters, 31.5 feet, in length. The massive size of Titanoboa is believed to be closely linked to the climate conditions of the Paleocene Epoch. As poikilothermic, cold-blooded, creatures, snakes rely on their surrounding temperature to regulate their metabolic rates and growth. To reach the impressive size of Titanoboa, a snake would require a significantly warm environment, which the Paleocene provided. The coal deposits at Serpent originated from a vast swamp that bordered an ancient shallow sea, located at the base of the early Andes Mountains. This prehistoric habitat resembled the swamps of North America's Mississippi River Delta or the Everglades, but existed in a tropical climate when the Earth was exceptionally warm. Titanoboa likely spent a considerable amount of time in water. Geological evidence and the presence of aquatic organisms, like mangrove-like plants, crocodilians, turtles, and fish, indicate that the area was predominantly waterlogged. Modern anacondas also prefer aquatic environments, often hiding among vegetation in shallow waters to ambush prey. Given its size, it's highly probable that Titanoboa had similar behaviors, as living on land would have been cumbersome or even unfeasible. The Titanoboa was not venomous and relied on physical means like constriction or blocking the windpipe to kill its prey, which consisted of smaller reptiles, birds, and small crocodiles. Its large size facilitated hunting and constriction. The dull coloration of the Titanoboa helped it approach prey unnoticed. Two theories suggest reasons for the extinction of Titanoboa. Climate change led to declining global temperatures, favoring smaller snakes and erasing larger reptiles like Titanoboa. The rapid temperature drop affected Titanoboa's metabolism. Habitat changes, including rainforest reduction and the rise of grasslands, also played a role in their extinction. Join us next time on Ahmed's World as we continue to explore the mysteries of our natural history. Remember to subscribe for more captivating stories from the depths of time and space. Until next time, keep exploring the wonders of our world.